This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for him coming at you from South Central. That's South Central Los Angeles. And as you can see here, there's bars on the windows all around, and there's a lot of greens growing. Now, this is formerly known as actually South Central. I guess the city renamed it to just South LA to try to, you know, make the problems go away because it sounds nicer. You know, South Central has like some negative connotations, but to me, it seems perfectly safe. But we are here in the daytime. But what we're here today to share with you guys actually is a unique food forest in South Central LA. As you can see here, I mean, you know, a lot of people in this whole neighborhood, lawns all the way down the street for miles and miles. And as you can see here, we got a lawn on this side, we got a sidewalk, and then we have this little patch of like no man's land. Technically it's owned by the city, but the residents have to actually maintain it. So actually, instead of growing lawns and maintaining lawns, I would encourage you guys to actually grow some food instead. And actually, that's what a resident here is actually doing just on the other side of the street. So he took out this 10-foot section by 150-foot section of city-owned property and just planted it out in literally a food forest. Some people might say that South LA is actually a food desert because there's not a whole lot of place to get fresh organic produce around, or just even produce. But here, everything's free for the picking. The guy that put this in, his name is Ron Finley. He actually encourages people to come here and pick. So actually right here, we got some arugula, and I'm gonna pick some of this arugula and eat it without getting in trouble. It's a really good arugula. So he has a whole bunch of different things growing, a lot of herbs. I see some strawberries, and check it out. December, there's even still eggplants growing. A lot of different herbs here on the bottom, oregano. I'm seeing some beets here. And check it out, even got some banana, quote unquote, trees. Technically, bananas aren't trees, they're herbaceous plants, but he's got some banana plants. I'm seeing some berries there as well. And oh, here's some mustard. What a nice kid grows some mustard. Even got peppers still on the plant here, and some tomatoes. Here's a pear tree. And check this out, man, aren't you guys jealous? Here's some like nice looking basil here. It might be good to take some cuttings off of. Got some flavorful basil. Also, he's got things like collard greens, a whole bunch of different kinds of herbs down in here, some mints. Some chicory or red dandelion. Once again, you're encouraged to pick and eat. That's the purpose of a food forest here anyways. One of the other things that's really cool about Ron Finley, and I got to know Ron actually just through some YouTube videos. I never actually met the guy, but he has a really cool YouTube video that talks about putting this in. And you know, he wants to encourage people to take out their lawns and put in food forests. And a matter of fact, he actually helps people do that for free. And I'll tell you guys how to contact him at the end of this video. Well, he helps put it in for free if you live in the South Central Los Angeles. And currently, he's helped over a dozen people put in some food forests in their front yard to, you know, take back the food desert and turn them into food forests. I think that's an excellent idea. I want to show you guys just a few more things, the elements of this garden that I really like. You know, along here, he has actually some brick pathways to kind of like, you know, walk through and get in. So in this way, you know, either side, you could reach in without actually walking on your beds. I think that's very important. Another thing he's done is actually raise the soil level. So I'm sure he's brought in some good organic compost to grow in so that he could have some amazing results, because, you know, it's my belief that the results are all in the soil. So it's very important to grow in some good organic compost, but also add things like the trace mineral rock dust and rock powders to really ramp up your production, make your plants healthier, and more importantly, make them more nutritious and taste the best. So he has a lot of common and also uncommon things. Actually, here's some lemongrass growing right here. And the one I want to show you guys is actually right here. This is actually called the New Zealand spinach, and this is actually a really great perennial ground cover if you're down here in Los Angeles where it doesn't freeze. Even in Northern California, I get away with growing this year-round. And they kind of have an oxalic, acidy taste, kind of like regular spinach. They're not related to the standard spinach, but actually down here in South Central LA, these taste the best I've ever tasted. Let's continue to move on and show you a few other things in this garden, and I'll share with you how, if you live in South Central, you can get a free garden by pay it forward system. How many of you guys have seen the movie Pay It Forward? If you haven't, actually, I recommend you guys watch it. It was a really excellent movie about paying it forward, or, you know, doing good deeds and good things will happen to you. And that's what Ron believes here. He'll help people put in gardens, but only if they're going to help the next person put in a garden as well. Another really cool landscaping plant could be this right here. This is actually called the pineapple sage, and you could actually use the leaves as, you know, a sage. You could actually pick them and you literally scratch and sniff and it smells like pineapples. Why I grow the pineapple sage is actually not for the sage itself. It actually also smells nice. I actually grow them for the flowers. So you can see here, this is totally in bloom, and this is an amazing food source that many people aren't aware of. I mean, literally just picking these little flower tips, and the hummingbirds like this plant. They'll stick their little beak in the flower and get the nectar out, which is right at the tip there, and I'll take and bite off just the very tip. I'll get that nectar. It'll taste so good, and then I'll eat the rest of the flower for some nice red pigments, which are basically antioxidants, so that you can stay healthy. How many of you guys lately have eaten your flowers? Other common flowers that are edible in your garden are, you know, flowers from zucchinis and from the onions. Those are definitely edible. Now, some of the other things like tomatoes and bell pepper flowers, I necessarily don't eat. But also things like fruit flowers on fruit trees generally are also edible, although some might not taste that good. I think last we're gonna take a look at this cool pomegranate tree. So, you know, he's really doing a lot here. He's planting things low to the ground covers, then he's planting things that are a little bit taller, and then even taller yet. And he has trees every once in a while to tower over everything. And the trees, when you grow them, can produce a microclimate underneath them. So they'll provide more shade if things are getting too much sun on them. You know, a tree will provide some shade. Oh, and it looks like he's got some of my favorite, green tree collards here. I'm gonna try some green South Central tree collards. It's pretty good. Be sure to check my video if you haven't seen already for a place called Centro's Nursery in LA, where you can actually purchase your own tree collard plants. Recommend the purple variety. They have the green and the purple at Centro's Nursery. These are some plants that you can literally plant once. They'll grow as a tree and they'll put out leaves for you day after day. And it's one of the most valuable plants that you should be growing, even if you have an apartment, a balcony, or a patio. Just get a big pot and plant the tree collards in there. You know, I'd recommend at least a wine barrel size so it could actually get nice and tall and the roots can expand. But I've even seen people grow them in small as like 10 or 25 gallon pots. So I've really enjoyed my stop here at Ron Finley's literally food forest in South Central. If you want to contact Ron or learn more about his organization, you want to visit him at lagreengrounds.org, where they'll share more and share with you how you can put your own food forest in for free. Now that's truly amazing. I definitely want to encourage more people like Ron to come out the woodwork to, you know, promote and actively promote people growing food instead of their lawn. I think it's one of the best things you can do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, keep on growing.